hit all the small towns in the district, see how many people we can find, and have a big rally today.
What cities are you going to?
We are going to Opie, Madison, Hamilton, Virgil, Ridley, Neustrawn, Waverly, Melbourne, Linden, Neosho Rapids, and Hartford.
So that's quite a few.
People like Carol and Glenn make those decisions on how to spend.
Well, then I think if you bring it down too much for local control, then your core district, those kids aren't going to get there.
I didn't say local funding. I said local control and flexibility of the money. So money like still flows from Topeka, but it comes in a pot.
Right. Well, you have the capital outlay fund, you got this, you got that, there's restrictions on what you can do and how
capital
you can move money
different.
Around and try and
get. But you've got risk money, you've got transportation money, you've got free and reduced school money, you've got ESL money, you've got all these different piles that come down with very little flexibility on the local level on how those are going to distribute that money. And you've got to be able to distribute that money. I'd like to visit with you for a few minutes this afternoon about why I want to become your next state senator. I think it's important to give back to your community. As a third generation auto dealer, my father and my grandfather instilled in me at a very early age that you have to be willing to give back to your community. And so I've tried to do that throughout my career. The things that I've been involved with in Emporia are extensive. I've been on the Chamber of Commerce. I've been involved with the United Way. I've served on many foundation boards and many charities trying to make Emporia a better place to live. I'd like to take that kind of attitude and go to Topeka and try to make the state of Kansas a better place to live, raise our families, and to work. The state of Kansas and the direction that it seems to be going, I have some real concerns with, and that's what's also inspired me to want to run for the Kansas Senate. I'm concerned about education and the direction that education and that funding is going with education. I'm also concerned about the economy of Kansas and the fact that we seem to be losing our youth to either the metropolitan areas of Kansas or, worse yet, they're moving out of state. I think I have some skills that I can offer, and I am anxious to begin work on those passionate things in Topeka when I'm elected state senator. Education is something that's been very important to me throughout my life. I currently have two daughters that attend public schools in Emporia, and I'm very concerned about their education and what's best for them. I also truly believe that education is the future of our state. We have to educate our young people to be able to compete and thrive in the state of Kansas when they complete their education. One of the concerns that I have about education is there appears to be a lack of funding on the part of the legislature of the state of Kansas. And as the money flows down to the local school boards, I don't think the local school boards have the flexibility that they need when the money flows down to provide the quality education that the kids need. I would like to see the local school boards have more flexibility to move the money around where it matters the most. Hopefully that will be in the classroom and learning opportunities to better educate our kids. Another component that I feel like we have to have in the state of Kansas is equalization. We have too much disparity between local property tax levies and valuation and how much each district can levy with 1 mil of property tax. And so we have to have the equalization component in there so that the wealthiest school districts are helping provide some of the some of those smaller districts with funding opportunities. And with that equalization component throughout the state, that makes things work a lot easier. As we all know, the Kansas economy has struggled for the last couple of years, and part of that is the nationwide economy has filtered down to Kansas, but it's also a population drop in Kansas. And so economic development is something that I'm very passionate about. I've spent many years here on the Economic Development Board in Emporia. I've chaired that organization for the majority of those years. I feel like I bring unique skills to the State House on how to attract private sector jobs, how to grow our economy, and I'd like to bring those skills to Topeka. One of the things that I've learned in my economic development work is that we need three basic components statewide for us to be successful. First of all is a competitive tax climate. We have to have a reasonable regulatory environment, and we have to have a good, strong transportation system so that we can get raw materials in. I think one of the things that is a key to Kansas's future success is the ability to identify leaders who have the ability to bring consensus groups together, to work across party lines, to leave partisan politics at home, and to bring people like business and education and state government together to sit down at the table and find real-world solutions, leave the politics at the front door, and let's sit down and decide what is best for the state of Kansas as a whole, and let's work towards those solutions. Being a novice to politics, I don't carry the baggage that or the allegiances that older politicians do. I don't have any particular allegiance to anyone in the State House, and so I think I can bring a new perspective, kind of being the new guy. I'm willing to talk to both sides of the aisle. I'm willing to talk to the conservatives and the traditional Republicans and work to find real-world solutions in Topeka.